Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. There were a series of interesting tweets posted by SpaceX yesterday. The first says today marks the 10th anniversary of completion of the COTS Demo Flight 2, Dragon's first mission to and from the space station. Next, they posted Dragon successfully docked with the orbiting lab on May 25th, becoming the first privately developed vehicle in history to successfully attach to the space station. There were some further tweets saying 6 days later, Dragon departed the space station and began its return to Earth. As well as that, they said, now 10 years later, SpaceX has a reusable Dragon fleet capable of supporting both crew and cargo missions. On Monday, the National Air and Science Museum posted a tweet about the 2-year anniversary of Crew Dragon Endeavour. It says, 2 years ago today, astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley launched to the ISS on board Crew Dragon Endeavour, NASA's first human spaceflight from American soil since the space shuttle retired. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. Crews have done a bit of work on the suborbital launch site Pad B mount. The work to complete the mega bay roof is continuing. Also in the production yard, work is continuing on the Star Factory production building. Chris Burgin posted a tweet with information from the FAA about the Starship environmental assessment. It says, the FAA intends to issue the final programmatic environmental assessment for the SpaceX Starship Super Heavy project on June 13, 2022. Interagency consultation is ongoing. The completion of the PEA will not guarantee that the FAA will issue a launch license. Somebody posted a tweet in reference to the environmental assessment. They said the comments have been released, all 19,000 of them. There's an article posted saying a judge is expected to hear a lawsuit June 1st concerning access restrictions to a South Texas beach amid SpaceX activities for the Starship program. This booster header tank that appears to have been repurposed was spotted. This Starship flap aero cover was spotted in the yard. Musk was asked on Twitter what's the status on the Sabatier fuel plant. Has SpaceX started working on the in-situ resource utilization plant that will be responsible for producing fuel to be used by Starship on Mars? He responded with, still early stages on that. Getting Starship reliably to orbit then achieving full and immediate reusability of both stages is by far top priority. In reference to a recent Everyday Astronaut video touring Starbase, Tim Dodd said, next time we've got to do it when there's a fully stacked Starship there. Musk responded and said, only a few weeks away. All Raptor 2 engines needed for first orbital flight are complete and being installed. In reference to a tweet about the capabilities of Starship with an infographic of a bunch of rockets, Musk responded. He said the specs on Wikipedia aren't quite right, but close enough. Thrust, liftoff mass, length and payload will grow over time. There was another tweet posted saying Starship, if launched, fully reusable will get approximately 150 tons of payload to orbit. Starship, if launched expendable, can get approximately 250 tons of payload to orbit. Why does the expendability increase the payload to orbit by this much? Musk responded and said the amazing part will be having an orbital rocket that is fully and rapidly reusable with any payload at all. Everyone else gave up when they realized that their fully reusable payload was less than zero. We still have a long way to go. Work has been continuing at the top of the old Ship 16 prototype. Here's a view of Ship 24 at the launch site. Crews have been working on the prototype since it performed some proof testing. Starship Gazer posted some pictures on Twitter of crews working on the Starship 24 prototype after the broken pipe. He said workers installed a new section of pipe with expansion loops in Starship 24 today to replace the section destroyed during Friday's testing, and they also removed this straight section. Looking at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, there is a closure scheduled for today. In addition, there are possible closures for tomorrow, Thursday 2nd and Friday 3rd. Work on the new nose cone, possibly for Ship 25, has been continuing. This nose cone has since been moved out of the tent. The Booster 8 engine section was moved out of a tent into the high bay for stacking. Musk was asked by Everyday Astronaut about what we can expect to see with some of the first Booster 7 static fire testing. He tweeted, I really can't wait to see the first super heavy static fire. Question is, will they do all 33 engines at once or just inner ring or outer ring static fires? Musk responded with just one at a time at first. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.